Check it. Good afternoon, I'm Bernard Wilson.
And I'm Oscar Hamilton. Just as a disclaimer, we are not hipsters. We just report on hipster activity.
Today in Hipster News, we will discuss the topic, Are You a Hipster? We will tell you what thrift stores to hit up. We will give you an inside look at the World Instant Ounce Tournament in Welland, Ontario, as well as keep you updated with the weather. Also, an inspiring story. And what mustache should you rock for the month of Movember?
The big question is, are you a hipster? Bernard, are you a hipster?
No, not at all.
Exactly. Neither am I. But people always ask themselves, am I a hipster? And I'm here to answer that question.
So what makes someone a hipster then, Oscar?
Well, Bernard, the number one rule is that you can never admit you're a hipster. Then you gotta start with the clothing. Let's go from head to toe. First, you have the beanie, a small toque-like hat that sits on top of the head. Then going down a level, you have the big, large, dark frame glasses, which are key to the hipster look. Then to top it all off, you have the option of wearing a scarf. The reason I say option is because it really comes down to the hipster's preference.
Now, the next thing that makes you a hipster is your interests. What type of movies do you like? What type of music do you like? If you like local bands or bands that no one else knows, I'm sorry to break it to you, but you are a hipster.
Now, we have Bernard on the field asking students of Niagara College what makes up a hipster. Bernard?
Hi, I'm Bernard Wilson. I'm here at Niagara College, Welland, Ontario, to ask students about the topic of hipsters. Let's go, shall we? Are you familiar with the term hipster?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, I've heard that before.
Yes.
Yep.
No, I have no idea what that is.
Okay, thanks. What would you say makes up a hipster?
I'd probably say something like someone who wears like plaid shirts a lot and maybe like dark black glasses, odd tattoos like anchors, you know, that kind of thing.
Wanting to be the first at something, wearing very ridiculous clothing.
Maybe they like avoid mainstream things. Wear a lot of plaid, dark frame glasses or something.
A lot of glasses, a lot of plaid, and no mainstream. What'd you just do there?
I was just insta-ouncing us.
Is that something hipsters would do?
I don't know, it's kind of under the radar, so.
Would you consider you to be a hipster?
Not a hipster.
No, not at all.
Not at all.
Definitely not.
Okay, thank you. I'm Bernard Wilson, Niagara College, Ontario. Back to you, Bernard.
Thanks, Bernard. Now way over to Oscar with the latest on thrift stores. Oscar.
Thanks, Bernard. In thrift store news, a lot of stores are beginning their Christmas sales today. Some thrift stores you should hit up are
Value Town, Great Will, and Thrift Store.
So, buy your ugly Christmas sweaters before they become way too mainstream. Other clothing you can purchase was mentioned in our earlier segment, Are You a Hipster?
The time to go to thrift stores is now. The reason being, because everything, and I mean everything, once again, that is everything, is on sale. Oscar and I went this morning to pick out our outfits for today. Isn't that right, Oscar?
No.
Anyways, clothing's going from 10% off to 100%. 80%. Yeah, 80% off. Anything you can possibly imagine clothing-wise is going on sale. So go now.
Up next, we will have Bernard with the full weather forecast. Welcome back. Now over to Bernard with the weather.
Today, we have a sunny day, but don't get your expectations up for too long because winter is approaching. The mainstream from the west is coming in hot. Well, not hot. It's going to be pretty fast. And technically, it's going to be pretty cold considering winter is on its way. The point I'm trying to make is you should stay indoors if you want to maintain your hipster status. People will also be swept away by this mainstream. It could be someone you know, it could be someone you don't know, or it could be someone you kind of know from a mutual friend that kind of knows that person. What I'm trying to get across here is that it could be anyone, including you. Now for the monthly weather update. In December, it will snow on the 14th, 15th, 17th, and of course the 25th, because what's Christmas without snow? How do we know this? Because we get the weather before anyone else does. Now over to Oscar with some sports talk. Oscar?
Insta-ounce, the new craze in sports this month. If you're not familiar with the sport, I'll break it down for you. It is an app on your phone that you take pictures with and add real intense filters that make the picture that much more hipster. Whoever has the most likes and comments wins. Simple as that. In fact, there is a World Insta-ounce tournament taking place here in Welland, Ontario, one of the least popular cities in the world. We have Oscar there with the lowdown. Oscar?
Hi, I'm Oscar Hamilton here at the first annual Insta-ounce competition in Welland, Ontario. Just steps away from me, the competition is taking place. Let's go take a look. Hundreds of hipsters have traveled to Niagara College residence to compete in the event. After a very, very long day, only 10 remain. Let's meet the top 10.
First up, we have at Dylon. Next is at @the_Francis, at Dizzy, at Danthan Industries, at Annie Lou, at Hipster99, at Glasses for Life, at Dan the Man, at _Gus, at McCall.
Hi, I'm here with at Danthan Industries, who is currently sitting at third place in the competition. So what made you start wanting to Insta-ounce?
Well, me and my friends pretty much started it, but it was mainly me, you know.
Nice. So what was your first Insta-ounce picture?
Well, one fine summer morning, I got my waffle maker out, flipped them out when they were done, drizzled some warm maple syrup on, then seductively powdered the powdered sugar away.
Nice. So do you play any other sports?
Well, play tennis. Well, online, once.
If you want to have a say in the winner, just visit www.instaounce.com/top10 and like and comment for the picture of your choice. I'm Oscar Hamilton. Back to you, Oscar.
Thanks, Oscar. Well, let's hope at Danthan Industries wins the tournament. If you want to vote, remember you can go to instaounce.com/top10 and just like the picture of your choice. In other sports news, the third annual Hipster Olympics is taking place in Berlin. What's that, you may ask? Well, it's when thousands of hipsters from across the world come together to compete in hipster sporting events. Some of the sporting events include the 200-meter unicycle dash, where hipsters will bring their homemade unicycles and to see which one is the fastest. Current world record holder is Jean-Sebastien with a time of 12.4 seconds. Another event is the best mustache, simply who just wears their lip hair the wisest. But we can't forget the biggest glasses, deepest V-neck, and most stylish scarf events.
Oh boy, am I excited for this. I've been growing my lip hair, or should I say, mustache, myself. I'm thinking around this time next year, I'll be able to contend and compete for first place.
But you're not a hipster.
Right. Well, hypothetically speaking, of course. In mustache news, it's that time of year again. It's Movember. To be exact, it's Movember 23rd. And by this time, whoever can grow a mustache probably already has. So if you see anyone without a mustache, feel free to give a giggle. If you're one of these hairy hipsters where growing mustaches comes easy, here are some stylish hipster looks you can pull off. The undercover brother. The abracadabra. The jihad jack. The connoisseur. And of course, the classic businessman. All of these styles will come easy to you if you can actually grow one.
Oh, come on, man, let it go.
Coming up after the break, we have an inspiring story that happened in Toronto, where a young man was rescued by the hipster lifestyle.
How to put Mio in water with Greg Doyle. Here we have a water bottle and our Mio. Then you open the water bottle like so and flip open the Mio as well. Put the glass on the table and pour the water into the cup. Let the water caress the inside of the glass as you stare with such emotion. Chuck the bottle and forget about it. Pick up your Mio and squirt. Let the Mio spread all across the inside of the glass and ooh, for a second time. Close the Mio, put it down, and drink away. Drink, gobble, 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 drink. And smash the glass down. Wipe your face and twinkle fingers. Tongue face.
Welcome back. A very heartwarming story occurred in Toronto this past week. A young man by the name of Atticus Ridge was skateboarding down Queen Street. While minding his own business, he was approached by a businessman with a knife. Unfortunately, the businessman got the better fight in this one, cutting off his arms and legs.
Sorry. This is where the story gets inspiring. From all the blood loss, he also lost part of his eyesight, and which caused him to get big, large frame glasses. Not knowing what to wear with these glasses, he decided to look online. Not knowing what a hipster was, he soon found out. He started to wear hipster clothing, listen to hipster music, and watch hipster movies, which he said made him feel like a whole new person. It calmed him down and made him less upset about the loss of his legs and arms. Atticus is not only a hipster, he is also the first hipster without arms or legs. Atticus has also started a local charity to give money to other amputees. If you want to donate, you can visit www.wheredomylegsgo.com or call the toll-free number at 1-800-I-HAVE-NO-ARMS. Once again, that is www.wheredomylegsgo.com or the toll-free number of 1-800-I-HAVE-NO-ARMS.
Wow, that sure is inspiring. You know what? I'm definitely gonna go donate today. And you should too, and you.
In other news, humans are not the only ones becoming hipsters. Their pets are too. This photo was leaked last night, showing a dog and cat longboarding down a road dressed as hipsters. We have not yet confirmed if the animals have dressed themselves or if the owners dress them. We will have that story for tomorrow's newscast.
Now I hope by listening to this newscast, you know that much more about hipsters. Coming up tomorrow, we will tell you what new internet site is the new craze. Why Oscar has a black eye.
What?
You'll see.
What?
Also, we'll have live breaking footage from Berlin while the Hipster Olympics are taking place. That's all for your hipster news today. See you hipsters tomorrow. I'm Bernard Wilson.
I'm Oscar Hamilton.
Once again, we are both not hipsters.
Why? What black eye, man?
Man, you'll find out. I can't tell them.
You made me spit up my water.
Yeah, you're gonna have to clean that up. Anyways, hipster news.